So good morning to everybody. Today's topic is cholesterol and HDL dynamo. What is the cholesterol is first isolated from bile. It literally means solid alcohol from bile. It is exclusively found in animals. It is the most abundant animal sterol. It is widely distributed in all cells and it is a major component of cell membranes and lipoproteins. So cholesterol is the most important sterol in human body. If you see the formula C27, H46 and O. Now the cholesterol possesses cyclopentanoferrihydrophenanthrene nucleus. This is the A, B, C are the phenanthrene rings. D is the cyclopentane ring. Now the phenanthrene ring attached with the cyclopentane ring. So hence it is known as cyclopentanoferrihydrophenanthrene nucleus. See, the A, B, C, D are completely fused. The rings are completely fused. So phenanthrene ring and cyclopentane ring completely fused. The numbers are indicates the carbons. See, here it is the carbons. The numbers are indicated carbons. So this cyclopentanoferrihydrophenanthrene ring contains the OH group at the C3, hydroxyl group at the C3, double bond present between the C5 and C6. Now the aliphatic side chain attached on the carbon 17. This aliphatic side chain contain the 8 carbons. So aliphatic side chain contain the 8 carbons and attached on the C17 at the carbon 17. And cholesterol contain the 5 methyl groups. See, here it is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So cholesterol contain the 5 methyl groups. And see, here it is the complete cholesterol structure. So this is the number indicates the carbon numbers. Here it is the HS are nothing but is a 46 numbered hydrogens. These are. And the hydroxyl group present at the C3, that is meaning carbon 3. And double bond present between the 5-6, carbon 5 and carbon 6. These are the 5 methyl groups, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. These out of 5 methyl groups, 2 are called the angular methyl groups. These 2 are angular methyl groups. This is the one, another one is. The angular methyl groups present on the carbon 10 and carbon 13. So angular methyl groups present on the carbon 13 and carbon 10. See, this is the complete structure of cholesterol. Now see that when you observe the cholesterol under the microscope, it shows the notches in the corner appearance. See, here it is the structure of the cholesterol under the microscope. This is a notch shape. This is a notch shape present at the corner. See, this is the corner. This is the notch one. See, this is a notch shape present at the corner. The melting point of cholesterol is 147 to 150 degrees Celsius. Generally, cholesterol associated with the fatty acids to form the cholesterol esters. So, cholesterol esters are formed from the esterification of the fatty acids. Where the esterification occurs? The esterification occurs at the OH group of C3. See, here it is, esterification occurs OH group, hydroxyl group. These hydroxyl group are present where? At the C3. Due to the presence of OH group, cholesterol is weakly amphiphilic in nature. So due to the presence of OH group, hydroxyl group, cholesterol is weakly amphiphilic in nature. The appearance of cholesterol is much higher in the membranes of subcellular organelles. So the membrane of subcellular organelles containing the high cholesterol. Now see the sources. The sources are exogenous and endogenous. If you see the exogenous, the cholesterol obtained from the diet approximately is 0.3 grams per day. The dietary rich cholesterols are butter, cream, milk, egg yolk and meat. So when you consume the eggs provide the 250 milligrams of cholesterol. Now see the endogenous. So generally cholesterol synthesis in the body from acetyl-CoA. So the acetyl-CoA is a main precursor for the formation of cholesterol. That is approximately 1 gram per day. Now see the sources continues. Cholesterol is derived from diet. from the de novo synthesis. Here it is, de novo synthesis is example, acetyl choline. From the hydrolysis of cholesterol esters. So the main sources are from the diet and de novo synthesis and hydrolysis of cholesterol esters. And the liver and intestine are contribute to the approximately 10% of the cholesterol synthesis. So liver and intestine approximately contribute about 10% of total synthesis in humans. All the tissues contain the nucleated cells. These nucleated cells are capable of cholesterol synthesis. So all the tissues contain the nucleated cells. These nucleated cells are capable of cholesterol synthesis, which occurs in the endoplasmic reticulum and the cytosol. So these are occurs in the endoplasmic reticulum and the cytosol. Now see the summary of major sources of liver cholesterol and its utilization. Now see here it is. So cholesterol obtained liver from the diet and cholesterol synthesis in liver and cholesterol obtained from the extrahepatic tissues. The liver obtained the cholesterol from the diet, from the extrahepatic tissues, and also synthesis takes place in the liver. Now the utilization of cholesterol, that is cholesterol utilized for the formation of bile salts and bile acids, and also cholesterol is lost in bile and also useful for the formation of the lipoproteins. Now see the occurrence. So cholesterol is widely present in body tissues. Cholesterol is found in largest amount in normal human adults. Through the individual organs, brain and nervous tissue contain the 2% of cholesterol. Liver is about contain the 0.3%. Skin contain the 0.3%. Intestinal mucosa contain the 0.2%. Adrenal cortex contain the some 10% or more. Corpus luteum is also rich in cholesterol. Cholesterol is mainly present in blood and bile, and it is usually a major constituent of gallstone. So gallstone is a contain the more cholesterol. So the cholesterol is amphipathetic in nature. Why? So because of the presence of hydroxyl group. So cholesterol is referred to as an amphipathetic molecule due to the that contain the hydrophilic and hydrophobic parts. So cholesterol contain the two parts, that is hydrophilic part and hydrophobic part. This green color is a hydrophobic part, red color that is a hydroxyl group, hydrophilic part. So the presence of hydroxyl group, the cholesterol is amphipathetic in nature. Where the hydroxyl group is present? At the C3, that is at the carbon 3 hydroxyl group are present in the cholesterol. Due to the presence of hydroxyl group, cholesterol is weakly amphipathetic in nature. So you have a question generally, so why the cholesterol is amphipathetic in nature? Then you have to give the answer is due to the presence of hydroxyl group, so cholesterol is amphipathetic in nature. It's containing the hydrophilic and hydrophobic parts. Now see the properties. So cholesterol is generally contain the color of the cholesterol white and faintly yellow granules. White or faintly yellow granules. So it is almost odorless. It is insoluble in water, but sparingly soluble in alcohol, but completely soluble in ether, chloroform, art alcohol, ethyl acetate, and vegetable oils. Completely soluble in ether, chloroform, art alcohol, ethyl acetate, and vegetable oils. Sparingly soluble in alcohol. Now see the molecular mass of the cholesterol. 386.654 grams per molar, boiling point 360 degrees Celsius, and density is 1.052 grams per centimeter cube. Now see the forms of the cholesterol. Cholesterol available in two forms, that is free form and ester form. In ester form, cholesterol esterification with the fatty acids at the OH group at C3 position. So it is available in two forms, that is free form and ester form. Ester form, in which it is esterified with the fatty acids at OH group and at C3 position. But ester form of cholesterol is also known as a bound form. So cholesterol is available in two forms, that is free form and bound form or ester form. So bound form or ester form, both are same. See, the forms availability in the individual organs. Brain and nervous tissues contain the free form, and whereas adrenal cortex containing the esterified form. So brain and nervous tissue containing the free form of cholesterol, that is more predominant, where the adrenal cortex containing the esterified form of the cholesterol. So cholesterol is essential for the synthesis of bile acids, hormones, that is like sex hormones and cortisol, and vitamins. Especially vitamins are example vitamin D. So cholesterol is essential for the synthesis of bile acids, hormones, and vitamin D. So cholesterol generally chooses the different functions in the human body, serves a variety of functions in the human body. This includes manufacture of steroids or cortisone like hormones, including vitamin D, and sex hormones, that is testosterone, estrogen, and cortisone. And cholesterol in turn to controls a myriad of body functions, and as a source of energy, is involved in the maintenance of our body temperature, protection of internal organs, modulation of the fluidity of cell membrane. So cholesterol is present in the tissues and plasma either as a free cholesterol as a storage form. So generally tissues and plasma contain either free form of cholesterol or storage form of cholesterol. So these together combined with the long chain fatty acids as a cholesterol esters. So maybe free cholesterol or storage form of cholesterol combined with the long chain fatty acids and form the as a cholesterol ester. In plasma, both forms are transported in lipoproteins. The both forms are mean here it is a free cholesterol form and storage form of cholesterol, both are transported in lipoproteins. What are the lipoproteins? The lipoproteins are HDL, LDL, VLDL, chylomicrons are the lipoproteins. Now see the function of the LDL. LDL acts as a vehicle for the uptake of cholesterol and cholesterol esters. So act as a vehicle for the uptake of cholesterol and cholesterol ester into many tissues. Now see the function of the HDL. The main function of the HDL, remove the free cholesterol from the tissues and transport it to the liver, where it is eliminated from the body either unchanged form or after conversion of to bile acid. This process is known as a reverse cholesterol transport. So generally you have a 2 marks question, what is the cholesterol reverse cholesterol transport? Then you have to give the answer. The HDL is to remove the free cholesterol from the tissues and transport it to the liver, where it is eliminated from the body either unchanged, that means unchanged means as a free cholesterol, or after conversion to bile acid. This process is known as a reverse cholesterol transport. Now see the biosynthesis of cholesterol. So the biosynthesis of cholesterol is may be divided into 5 steps. The first step is biosynthesis of our formation of mavalnate. This is occurs from the esterase. Second one is formation of isoprenoid units from the mavalnate by loss of carbon dioxide. Third step is condensation of 6 isoprenoid units from the scalene. That means is the formation of scalene. Fourth one is cyclization of scalene to give rise to the parent steroid or lanosterol. And finally, formation of the cholesterol from the lanosterol. So what are the steps? That is from the cholesterol synthesis, mavalnate, formation of the mavalnate, first one. Second one is formation of the isoprenoid units. Third one is formation of the scalene. And the fourth one is formation of the lanosterol. And fifth one is formation of the cholesterol from the lanosterol. Now see the cholesterol synthesis occurs in the cytosol. Don't forget, occurs in the cytosol. Here it is, 2 molecules of acetyl-CoA condense form the acetoacetyl-CoA. The 2 molecules of acetyl-CoA condense and produce the acetoacetyl-CoA by thiolase enzyme. Now the acetyl-CoA is reduced to produce the HMG-CoA. HMG-CoA synthase acted upon the acetyl-CoA produce the HMG-CoA. Now see the importance of the HMG-CoA synthase. This HMG-CoA synthase formed in two forms. That is, the one is present in the mitochondria. So another one present in the cytosol. So cytosol containing HMG-CoA synthase involved in the synthesis of cholesterol. Mitochondrial containing HMG-CoA synthase involved in the formation of ketone bodies. Don't forget. So existing two pools, that is HMG-CoA synthase that is present in the mitochondria involved in the synthesis of ketone bodies. HMG-CoA synthase that is present in the cytosol involved in the formation of the cholesterol. Now this HMG-CoA reduced to mavalonate by the HMG-CoA reductase. Now this mavalonate is converted to 3-phospho-5-pyrophosphomavalonate by the three kinases action. By the three kinases. See, here it is. Mavalonate kinase acted upon the mavalonate, produced the 5-phosphomavalonate. Again, kinase acted upon the 5-phosphomavalonate, produced the 5-pyrophosphomavalonate. Now, the third kinase acted upon the 5-pyrophosphomavalonate, produces the 3-phospho-5-pyrophosphomavalonate. So, the how many kinases are involved in the conversion of mavalonate to 3-phospho-5-pyrophosphomavalonate? Three kinases are involved in the formation of 3-phospho-5-pyrophosphomavalonate from the mavalonate. Now, 3-phospho-5-pyrophosphomavalonate undergoes the decarboxylation. This is the release of carbon dioxide. Undergoes the decarboxylation by the decarboxylase, produces the isopentanyl pyrophosphate. See, here it is. Isopentanyl pyrophosphate is a 5-carbon compound. This isopentanyl pyrophosphate undergoes the isomerization, produces the dimethylyl pyrophosphate. Dimethylyl pyrophosphate. This is also 5-carbon compound. Okay. These two together condense, produce the geranyl pyrophosphate. So the 5-carbon compound isopentanyl pyrophosphate and condensed with the 5-carbon compound dimethylyl pyrophosphate produce the geranyl pyrophosphate. This geranyl pyrophosphate is a 10-carbon compound. Now again, this isopentanyl pyrophosphate, see here it is, condensed with the geranyl pyrophosphate. See, here it is, geranyl pyrophosphate. See, isopentanyl pyrophosphate, see here it is, condensed with the geranyl pyrophosphate, produce the farnesyl pyrophosphate. So this is the 15-carbon compound. Again, this farnesyl pyrophosphate, two molecules of the farnesyl pyrophosphate condensed together, produce the farnesyl pyrophosphate. Farnesyl pyrophosphate. So this farnesyl phosphate condensed to produce the scalene by the scalene synthase. Scalene synthase. Now see the conversion of the scalene to lanosterol. Scalene undergoes the hydroxylation, cyclization by utilizing the NADPH and oxygen. See, here it is. Utilizing the NADPH and oxygen produce the lanosterol. So this lanosterol contains 30 carbons. By epoxidase enzyme, hydroxylase enzyme, and cyclization. So, cyclization reaction, hydroxylase reactions, it produces the lanosterol. So, scalene produces the lanosterol by utilizing NADPH and oxygen. Now, see the formation of cholesterol from the lanosterol. So, lanosterol is converted to the cholesterol. It is occurs through the 19 series of reactions. Now see the conversion of lanosterol to cholesterol. That means is the formation of cholesterol. During the formation of cholesterol, some changes occurs. What are the changes that occurs? See, here it is. The formation of cholesterol from the lanosterol takes place in the membrane of the endoplasmic reticulum. So, lanosterol, the cholesterol, the formation of the cholesterol from the lanosterol takes place in the membrane of the endoplasmic reticulum and involves the changes in the steroid nucleus and side chains. Don't forget, involves in the changes in steroid nucleus and side chain. The changes occurs in steroid nucleus and side chain. What are the changes? See, here it is. The first one is remove the methyl groups. See, here it is. The methyl groups are removed from C14 and C4. So from the carbon 14, from the carbon 4, remove the methyl groups to form the 14 dismethyl lanosterol and then gymosterol. Now the second step is shift the double bonds. The double bonds are subsequently moved from C8 to C5. That's meaning shift the double bonds from C8 to C5. That is occurs in two steps, forming the desmosterol. Finally, the double bonds are reduced, present between the C24 and C25, producing the cholesterol. So, what are the changes occur? Remove the methyl groups, and second one is shift the double bonds, and third one is double bonds are reducing, that is present between the C24 and C25, producing the cholesterol. See, here it is, complete structure of cholesterol. See, here it is. There is a ring ABCD, cyclopentanol for a hydro ring. It's containing the OH group, and here it is a double bond present between the C5 and C6, and methyl groups are present. So angular methyl groups are present between the C10 and C13. And here it is a side chain add on the carbon 17. Okay, there is a complete final structure of the cholesterol. Now see the regulation of cholesterol. The regulation of cholesterol by feedback mechanism, by hormonal regulation, by inhibition by drugs. Here it is, regulation of cholesterol. Cholesterol biosynthesis controlled by the HMG-CoA reductase enzyme. So HMG-CoA reductase is a rate limiting enzyme involved in the regulation of cholesterol biosynthesis. It is mainly found in association with the endoplasmic reticulum. So HMG-CoA reductase is found in association with the endoplasmic reticulum. So increase in cellular concentration of cholesterol reduce the synthesis of the enzyme HMG-CoA reductase. So the when the cholesterol levels are increased, then the synthesis of enzyme, that is HMG-CoA reductase, is decreased. Now see the hormone regulations. HMG-CoA exists in two interconvertible forms. So it exists in two forms. The two forms are interconvertible. What are they? Dephosphorylated form and phosphorylated form. So HMG-CoA reductase exists in two forms, that is dephosphorylated form and phosphorylated form. Dephosphorylated form is more active and phosphorylated form is less active. Dephosphorylated form is more active, phosphorylated form is less active. Now see the hormones glucagon and glucocorticoids are favored for the formation of inactive HMG-CoA reductase. Inactive HMG-CoA reductase means this is favorable to the phosphorylated form of HMG-CoA reductase. So this is favorable for the phosphorylated form of HMG-CoA reductase. Then decreases the cholesterol synthesis. Now see the insulin and thyroxine hormones increase the cholesterol production by enhancing the formation of active HMG-CoA reductase. So insulin and thyroxine increase the cholesterol production by enhancing the formation of active HMG-CoA reductase. That means this is favored for the dephosphorylated form of HMG-CoA reductase. Now, inhibition by drugs. The drugs pampactin and lavastatin are used for the decrease the serum cholesterol levels in patients with hypercholesterolemia. Generally, normal human bodies does not contain the hypercholesterolemia. So, The drugs compactin and lavastatin are used to decrease the serum cholesterol level in patients with hypercholesterolemia. These two drugs are competitive inhibitors of the enzyme HMG-CoA reductase. So compactin and lavastatin are the competitive inhibitors of the HMG-CoA reductase. So therefore, they reduce the cholesterol synthesis. But HMG-CoA synthesis activity is inhibited by the bile acids. Fasting also reduces the activity of HMG-CoA reductase enzyme. So you have this one doubt. Actually, serum cholesterol levels are estimated for the estimation. Blood sample is fasting blood sample is required. Why? So because of here it is. The answer is are here only. The fasting also reduces the activity of the enzyme. That means HMG-CoA reductase activity also reduced in fasting condition. So in fasting condition, HMG-CoA reductase activity is decreased. Now see the transport of cholesterol. How the cholesterol is transported? Cholesterol is present in the plasma lipoproteins in two forms. That is esterified form and free form. So about 70 to 75% it is an esterified form with long chain fatty acids. About 25 to 30% is a free cholesterol. The free cholesterol is readily exchanged between the different lipoproteins and also with the cell membrane. The free cholesterol form of the free cholesterol is readily exchangeable between different lipoproteins and also with the cell membranes. Here it is a lipoprotein species, nothing but is a HDL, LDL, VLDL and chylomicrons. Now see the role of LCAT in transport of cholesterol. LCAT means is lecithin cholesterol acid transferase. The HDL, the high density lipoproteins and the enzyme lecithin cholesterol acid transferase are responsible for the transport and elimination of cholesterol from the body. So the lipoprotein, that is HDL and LCAT, both are responsible for the transport and elimination of cholesterol from the body. The normal value of cholesterol is 150 to 200 milligrams per deciliter. But newborns contain the 100 milligrams per deciliter. But the value is rise after 1 year, within 1 year. That is about 150 milligrams deciliter. So women have relatively lower plasma cholesterol. The plasma cholesterol associated with the different lipoprotein fractions, that is like LDL, VLDL and HDL. The total cholesterol can be estimated by many methods. Now see the estimation of cholesterol. So many methods are available. That is, one is such as Lieberman-Buschert action, Hare and Doctor method, cholesterol oxidase method. Now see the hypercholesterolemia. When the plasma cholesterol levels are increased more than 200 milligrams per deciliter is known as a hypercholesterolemia. This hypercholesterolemia is observed in many disorders, that is diabetes mellitus, in hyperthyroidism, obstructive jaundice, nephrotic syndrome. So diabetes mellitus, hypothyroidism, obstructive jaundice and nephrotic syndrome. In diabetes mellitus, the cholesterol levels are increased since the availability of acetyl-CoA increased. So the in diabetes mellitus, cholesterol levels are increased mainly due to the availability of the acetyl-CoA is increased. So acetyl-CoA levels are, the availability is increased, then the cholesterol levels are increased in diabetes mellitus. In hyperthyroidism, due to the decrease in the HDL receptors on hepatocytes. So HDL receptors are decreased on hepatocytes in hypothyroidism. In obstructive jaundice, due to an obstruction in the excretion of cholesterol through the bile. So obstruction occurs in the excretion of cholesterol through the bile. In nephrotic syndrome, increase the plasma globulin concentration. So that when the plasma globulin concentration is increased in nephrotic syndrome, cholesterol levels are increased. Hypercholesterolemia is associated with the atherosclerosis and coronary disease, coronary heart diseases. This is associated with the atherosclerosis and coronary heart diseases. Now, how to control the hypercholesterolemia? By using is by consumption of PUFA, plant sterols, and dietary fiber. PUFA, that is, here it is a polyunsaturated fatty acids. PUFA means is polyunsaturated fatty acids. Consumption of PUFA, intake of polyunsaturated fatty acids reduce the plasma cholesterol levels. When you consume the more PUFA containing diet, then cholesterol levels are decreased. PUFA will help transport the cholesterol by LCAT mechanism. So previously I told you LCAT and HDL involved in the transport the cholesterol. So PUFA will help in transport of cholesterol by LCAT mechanism. Plant sterols. Certain plant sterols and their esters reduce the plasma cholesterol levels. They inhibit the intestinal absorption of dietary cholesterol. So when you consume the plant sterols, so certain plants contain the sterols, the esters and their esters reduce the plasma cholesterol levels. Dietary fiber. Fiber present in vegetables decrease the cholesterol absorption from the intestine. Now see the hypocholesterolemia. Hypocholesterolemia is very less common, but decrease in the plasma cholesterol also is less common, is also observed in hyperthyroidism, hyperthyroidism, pernicious anemia, malabsorption syndrome, and hemolytic jaundice. Hypocholesterolemia is observed in hyperthyroidism. Hypercholesterolemia is observed in hypothyroidism. Don't forget, hypercholesterolemia observed in hypothyroidism, but hypocholesterolemia observed in hyperthyroidism. This is hypo, hyper. So hypercholesterolemia, hypocholesterolemia observed in hyperthyroidism, pernicious anemia, malabsorption syndrome, and hemolytic jaundice. Now see the metabolism of HDL. High density lipoproteins, HDL means is high density lipoproteins, they are synthesized in the liver. It is also known as a good cholesterol. So why? Because it removes the cholesterol from the blood and returns it to the liver. It removes the cholesterol from blood and returns it to the liver. Actually, this HDL contains the free cholesterol and phospholipids and apoproteins. The apoproteins are apoprotein A, apoprotein C2 and E. So HDL contains the free cholesterol and phospholipids and apoproteins. Now see the role of LCAT in HDL metabolism. The plasma enzyme LCAT, that is lecithin cholesterol acyl transferase, that catalyzes the esterification of free cholesterol present in the extrahepatic tissues and transfer to the HDL. So that the main function of the LCAT catalyzes the esterification of free cholesterol that is present in the extrahepatic tissues and transfer to the HDL. So ultimately, transport the free cholesterol, esterification of free cholesterol to HDL. The apoprotein A promotes the activity of LCAT. Apoprotein A promotes the activity of LCAT. HDL also accepts the free cholesterol from other lipoproteins. So HDL also accepts the free cholesterol from other lipoproteins, not only the LCAT. Also, accept from other lipoproteins in circulation and cell membrane of peripheral tissues. Why the HDL particle becomes spherical? Due to the addition of cholesterol, HDL particle becomes spherical. The HDL particles with cholesterol esters trapped inside and enter the hepatocytes by a receptor mediated endocytes. The HDL particles with cholesterol esters trapped inside enter into the hepatocytes by a receptor-mediated endocytes. In the liver, cholesterol esters are degraded to cholesterol. So cholesterol is degraded, takes place in the liver only. The later it is utilized for the synthesis of bile acids and lipoproteins are excreted into the body. This liberated cholesterol utilized for the synthesis of bile acids and lipoproteins. So from the circulation is HDL is entered into the hepatocytes. In the liver, the cholesterol esters are degraded to the cholesterol. Now this liberated cholesterol utilized for the synthesis of bile acids and lipoproteins are excreted into bile. So involved in the synthesis of bile acids and lipoproteins are excreted into the bile. Now see the function of HDL. The main function of HDL, transport of the cholesterol from peripheral tissues, the liver, for the degradation and excretion. So cholesterol for the degradation and excretion, HDL is required. The transport of the cholesterol from the peripheral tissues to the liver for its degradation and excretion, HDL is required. HDL serves as a reservoir of apoproteins. So as a apoproteins, they accept the apoproteins, that is apoprotein C2 and apoprotein E, and donate the same to other lipoproteins. So they accept the apoproteins. These apoproteins are donated to the other lipoproteins, chylomicrons and VLDL. The apoprotein C2 of HDL serves as an activator of lipoprotein lipase. So ApoC2 serves as an activator of lipoprotein lipase. Now see the estimation of cholesterol. Enzymatic coupled Trindade method, estimation of cholesterol by enzymatic coupled Trindade method. Now see the aim, to estimate the amount of cholesterol that is present in the given serum or plasma. See the principle, here it is a cholesterol ester, hydrolase the hydrolase, cholesterol ester, hydrolase, hydrolase the, form the cholesterol and free fatty acids. So cholesterol ester, hydrolase the hydrolase is the fatty acids, reduce the form cholesterol esters and converting them to free cholesterol. This free cholesterol is reacted by the cholesterol oxidase producing the hydrogen peroxide. Now this free cholesterol is reacted by the cholesterol oxidase produce the hydrogen peroxide. Now the peroxidase enzyme acts upon the hydrogen peroxide to produce the nascent oxygen. See here it is, hydrogen peroxide is acted by the peroxidase enzyme produce the nascent oxygen. This one is acted upon the PAP, para amino antipyrene, to produce the pink color. This pink color can be measured in calorimeter at 540 nanometers and cholesterol can be estimated. Now see the procedure. Take a 3 test tubes and label them blank, standard and test. Now the requirement, reagent requirements, distilled water, standard, serum or plasma, cholesterol reagent. Now add one by one. Add the distilled water about 10 microliters in blank test tube. Add the standard about 10 microliters in standard test tube. Add the serum or plasma in test tube about 10 microliters. Now add the cholesterol reagent in all the 3 test tubes about 1 ml. Now mix the tubes thoroughly. Incubate at 37 degrees Celsius for 5 minutes. Now then, read the absorbance of standard and samples again in the blank at 540 nanometers. The 540 nanometers contain the green filter. Now see the estimation of cholesterol concentration, that is in milligrams per deciliter. So take the OD of test divided by OD of standard into concentration of standard. So now see the results. The amount of total cholesterol in the given sample, that is found by enzymatic coupled Trindade method. So whatever you get, that is maybe is a 200 or 140 or 130. So 130 milligrams per deciliter. Now see the clinical significance. Hypercholesterolemia. The elevated levels of cholesterol are known as hypercholesterolemia. This is mainly observed in atherosclerosis, diabetes mellitus, nephrotic syndrome, biliary obstruction and hypothyroidism. Hypolipoproteinemia. This hypolipoproteinemia mainly due to the administration of insulin, thyroid hormones, high blood pressure, in smoking, the abdominal obesity, the lack of exercise, you can observe the hypolipoproteinemia. So these factors, that is stress, coffee, and various diseases, which increase the free fatty acids. So the stress, coffee, and various diseases, so it increases the free fatty acids. Hypocholesterolemia. What is hypocholesterolemia? The decrease the levels of, decrease the cholesterol levels are known as hypocholesterolemia. This is observed in hyperthyroidism, hepatitis, so cirrhosis of liver, malabsorption, anemia, hemolytic jaundice. Some other methods are available for the estimation of the cholesterol. That is Lieberman-Burchard method, modified Lieberman-Burchard method, for the free and esterified cholesterol method. For free and esterified cholesterol method. Now see the estimation of HDL cholesterol by phosphotangustic acid, by precipitation or colorimetric method. AM. To estimate the amount of HDL cholesterol present in given serum or sample. Principle. In the presence of phosphotangustic acid and magnesium chloride, LDL, VLDL and thyromicrons are precipitated. So when you take this phosphotangustic acid and magnesium chloride, LDL, VLDL and thyromicrons are precipitated and centrifuged. HDL is collected as a supernatant and cholesterol content can be detected. So for the precipitation of LDL, VLDL and thyromicrons required the precipitating reagent about 500 microliters. So procedure, take the three tests marked as a so blank, standard and test. Now requirement of the reagents, that is in ml, distilled water, standard, serum or plasma, cholesterol working reagent and supernatant. Take the distilled water, that is 10 microliters into the blank tube. Take the standard, about 10 microliters in the standard tube. So take the serum or plasma, 10 microliters, add into the test tube. Now add the cholesterol working reagent in all three test tubes, about 1 ml, 1 ml, 1 ml. Now take the supernatant, that is 50 microliters, add into the test. Mix the test tubes, so each individually, thoroughly. Incubate for 10 minutes at 37 degrees Celsius. Read the absorbance of standard sample against reagent blank at 540 nanometers. So cholesterol also, HDL and HDL cholesterol both are the read at 540 nanometers, that is green filter. See, the normal ranges are male contain the 40 milligrams per deciliter, females contain the 50 milligrams per deciliter. Now see the calculation. HDL cholesterol, that is also milligrams per deciliter. Take the ODs of test divided by ODs of standard into concentration of standard, that is in milligrams per deciliter. Other method also available for the estimation of HDL cholesterol, that is dextran sulfate method. Dextran sulfate method is available for the estimation of HDL cholesterol. Now see the LDL cholesterol. Low density lipoprotein cholesterol was estimated by simple calculation using Thredwald formula. That is, VL estimation of VLDL cholesterol by triglycerides divided by 5. Take the triglycerides value, that is divided by 5, you can get the VLDL cholesterol. Now, total cholesterol minus VLDL cholesterol plus HDL, you can get the LDL cholesterol value. The normal ranges of VLDL, 35 to 40 milligrams per deciliter, LDL is less than 130 milligrams per deciliter. CRTs once again. So, cholesterol is first isolated from bile. It is the most important animal sterol. So, it contains the four rings, that is four rings are fused rings, that is A, B, C, D. So, these A, B, C are the phenanthrin rings, D are the cyclopentane ring. So, cyclopentane ring attached with the phenanthrin ring, so hence it is called the cyclopentane parahydrophenanthrin rings. So, cyclopentanone parahydrophenanthrin nucleus. It's contained the double bonds between the C5 and C6 and hydroxy group present at the C3 carbon. This is the C3 carbon. And it contains the 5-methyl groups, that is C, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So out of these five methyl groups, two are called the angular methyl groups. The angular methyl groups are present on the carbon 10 and carbon 13. Present on the carbon 10 and carbon 13. Here it is the side chain attached on the carbon 17. This side chain contains the 8 carbons. This side chain contains the 8 carbons. The steroid nucleus represents the saturated carbons. These are all the steroid nucleus contains the saturated carbons. These the indicates the reticular. Numbers are indicates the carbon numbers. Here it is the H46. There is a number of H's. The 46 number H's. So, and also when you observe the cholesterol in under the microscope, it shows is a notch shape. That is notch is notch is present in the at the corner. See, here it is a notch. The melting point of the cholesterol is 147 to 150 degrees Celsius. The esterification occurs at the OH group of the C3. Esterification occurs at the OH group of the C3. Due to the presence of OH group, so cholesterol is weakly amphipheric in nature. You have is one question, why it is cholesterol is amphipheric in nature? Due to the presence of OH group, cholesterol is weakly amphipheric in nature. And also cholesterol is higher content that is present in the membrane of subcellular organelles. And also here it is a liver and intestine are the contributes the 10% of the cholesterol. Here it is an occurrence. Brain and nervous tissue contain the 2%, liver in the liver about 3%, skin contain 0.3%, intestinal mucosa contain the 0.2%, but adrenal cortex and contain the more than 10%. Corpus luteum is also rich in cholesterol. So cholesterol is present in bread and bile acids are usually major constituents of gallstones. So why the cholesterol is amphiphilic in nature means it contains in the two parts, that is hydrophilic part and hydrophobic part. Here it is a hydroxyl group is a hydrophilic part. So the remaining ring is a hydrophobic part. So cholesterol contains the both two parts, that is hydrophilic part and hydrophobic part. Hydrophilic part is OH group is hydrophilic part. Hydrophobic part is the green color. Here it is. The hydroxyl group is able to form the hydrogen bonds. So the importance of this hydroxyl group is able to form the hydrogen bonds and involved in the formation of amphiphilic nature of the cholesterol. And also, due to the presence of OH group, cholesterol is weakly amphiphilic. So now see the properties this is almost waterless, insoluble in water, but completely soluble in ether, chloroform, hot alcohol, ethyl acetate, and vegetable oils, but sparingly soluble in alcohol. There are existing two forms, cholesterol exists in two forms, that is in free form and esterified form, in which it is esterified with the fatty acids. The esterification form, generally esterification with the fatty acids at OH group at C3 position. The ester form also known as a bond form. So the cholesterol containing the free form and bond form. The brain and nervous tissue contain the free form is more, and whereas adrenal cortex containing the esterified form. Cholesterol is essential for the synthesis of bile acids, hormones, vitamin D, that is a cortisol, and sex hormones, testosterone, estrogen, and cortisol. And as is involved in the maintenance of body temperature, production of internal organs, modulatory the fluidity of cell membrane. Cholesterol is present in the tissues and plasma, either free cholesterol form or storage form. But both are, that is free cholesterol form and storage form are combined with the long chain fatty acids as a cholesterol esters. The both forms are transported in lipoproteins. In plasma, both forms are transported in the lipoproteins, that is free form of cholesterol and storage form of cholesterol. LDL is act as a vehicle for the uptake of cholesterol and cholesterol esters into many tissues. So what is the reverse cholesterol transport? The reverse cholesterol transport means free cholesterol is removed from the tissues by plasma HDL and transport to the liver. So the HDL is involved in the transport of the cholesterol from the tissues to the liver. So where it is eliminated from the body, either unchanged form or after conversion of the bile acids. So this is the regarding about the chemistry. Thank you to all.